number 21.
The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Longhorns have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
Check, check. Dancer, dancer.
Watch the motion.
He's tackled at the 43-yard line.
First down.
Three down. Mike 7.
Green 9.
Green 9.
Panther 2.
Motion.
The tailback picks up a solid 7 yards on the counter play.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
Down.
They go to the left for a nice game. And that's their 3rd first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Kill.
Brought down at the 21-yard line.
That's not everyday speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision.
Three down.
Check.
Green 9.
Inside the 10, and down he goes around the 7-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. They'll get him for a loss. Loss of 1 there for the halfback.
That is a textbook tackle right there. He leveled his shoulders and just put his whole body weight behind that one. Great hit.
Shows some moves and he's in. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's an 8-play, 75-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. It can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
So the score now, 7-0. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers.
Second and 10.
Ball on the 25.
Mike 3. Combo.
Bring down. Let's go.
Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's taken down right around the 36-yard line. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. He's at midfield. Nice grab on the play. Tackle made at the 43.
Great job by the quarterback. He had a slant called against zone coverage and threw it at the perfect time.
He's taken down at the 34-yard line. Up.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
Mike 3.
dribbles it in, and he's in the open field. The offense was pretty successful on that play there.
That was a very good passing play to get the ball downfield for a very nice gain and a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 19. Makes the catch, and look out. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Try and scramble. And he hits him hard at the one. Touchdown, Red Raiders. Short burst for the score.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. A 10-play, 75-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. Texas Tech is ready to kick it away. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. And they make the stop at the 26-yard line. Here's the call from the referee.
Delay of game. Offense.
That penalty will move them back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
From their own 21-yard line. Second down. They'll make the sack.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
Black five. And he's sacked. Back-to-back sacks.
Well, just a great series for the defense to force the three and out and get that kind of pressure on the quarterback.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. You can bet the punter's sweating to have to kick this one from his own end zone. And this one is a beauty. He's tackled at the 48, so he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
On the run, and And he's tackled around the 26-yard line. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
They'll bring him down around the 16-yard line. We played one quarter. We get a tie game at 7-7. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two.
I'm coming, baby. I'm coming, baby. Woo! Mike three. Mike three. Check.
Alert, predator. Predator.
Tackle at the 12-yard line. It's third down and seven to go. Ball on the 12-yard line. They go back to him on a quick throw. And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
Tacks on the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Yard line.
Call it a game.
Man left, man left.
First down.
Three down. Seven to Mike. Mike seven. Hit. And two. Go.
He's got it out to his tight end. And he's level at the 43-yard line.
Number one makes the tackle at the 43-yard line. That brings him second and five.
Easy. Easy. 15. Go.
Gets out to around the 48.
That's good for being in the yards. That makes it first and 10.
Here we go, here we go.
He's at the 40. The senior makes the catch. Brought down at about the 33-yard line.
First down.
Tackles him hard at the 21.
First down.
Easy.
He fights forward to about the 19.
That'll make it second and seven.
From the 19-yard line, second down. Gets out to around the 9.
That's good for being at 10 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Mike 7. Black 5. Black 5.
He makes it to the 6-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3.
That brings him second and goal.
Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback.
That makes it third and goal.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Tie right.
They'll They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete.
Number 85 was the intended receiver.
This isn't much more than an extra point.
That brings up fourth and goal.
It's up, and they tack on 3 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Texas Tech holds a four-point lead. And he can't get away from the pressure.
That's a loss of 80 yards. That'll make it second and long.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. Now he's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. That's a great tackle at the 34. Complete. He's got space to work. And down he goes
at about the 43-yard line.
Got a man. Watch out here. And he is drilled at the 48-yard line. Quick throw to the back, it's incomplete. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Taken down at about the 39-yard line. Texas Tech is up by four. He's scrambling. Very good tackle in space. Called his own number on that one.
I like the idea of trying to run here, but the defense really made him pay the price for trying to run.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. And he's hit immediately. Now he tries to buy some time. Tackle made at the 27. Receiver and he can't make the grab.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith in your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Fires quickly to the tight end. He's taken down at the 20.
Texas Tech's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
Here's the 12th play of the drive.
That makes it third and three.
And he's immediately tackled. Caught, and he's hit immediately. Texas Tech is up four.
You know,
pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From the 15-yard line, third down. Quick throw in the end zone, touchdown. The second catch for six he's registered today.
Well, it's obvious the coach wanted to get him involved in the game plan. It looks like it was a pretty smart move, too.
And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Longhorns struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game, and sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how it can do. They got to get the ball in his hand somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play. One touch could get this guy going because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
So it's second down and 15 after the penalty.
Three down. Seven's a Mike. Mike seven.
Red.
Goes to the tight end, and it's knocked away. Takes it, and he's tackled short.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking scheme. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Booming kick. Looking for the corner. He got hit hard. Texas Tech's really putting a hurting on him right now.
Well, you wonder if it was a coach or a player who kind of lit the fire under this offense, but we've seen a completely different looking team, and they're executing at a much higher level.
The last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
Fires that quickly to the tailback. Certainly not what we expected as we head to halftime. The Red Raiders in front by 11.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
I can only hope that Nestler and Herb Street will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Excellent kick. Taking the field again now is the offense, and I got to tell you, these guys have just been a defensive nightmare on the past few drives. Quick
quick strike to the receiver.
And they make the stop at the 33-yard line.
They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Complete. He's got room to work.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Nice run there.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
Makes it out to about the 33. Throws it deep. Drops it. It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. Deep ball, laying it out there. Touchdown, Texas Tech. And he converts the extra point. A 7-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll knock him down for a loss. 1 yard loss for the halfback. From their own 24-yard line, 2nd down. But he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. And he hits him hard at the 15-yard line. After the sack, it's now 4th and long. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He makes it to the 48-yard line. The Longhorns have simply rocked the college football world with an astounding effort in this one.
This is one of the biggest upsets I think we've seen all year. You know what's great? They didn't worry about any of the outside distractions. They just kind of locked in to themselves and their coaches, getting ready for this football game, and it's really paid off for them.
Gets it out in a hurry. They'll bring him down around the 27-yard line. A good looking pass that time.
Well, here they do a nice job of getting the ball out to their speedy receiver, and he shows you that he not only can turn on the jets, but he's got pretty decent hands as well.
Man. attack on in the yardage. Rid of this one. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
The penetration by the defense was so good on that play that it didn't matter who the ball carrier was. Anyone would have been brought down for a loss.
He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Red Raiders continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
He's tackled at the 36. And he's tackled at the 36-yard line.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
He scrambled. Diving for extra yardage. He's at the 40, brought down at the 37. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Makes it out to about the 23. Inside the 10. He gets to about the 5. That last carry puts him over the century mark for the game.
We've seen this guy dominate over the course of today's game, and this drive has pretty much told the story. I mean, this offense is just steamrolling right down the field.
First and goal from the 5, and looking to cap this off with a touchdown. Scrambling around, and he's level at the 10.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Here's the 8th play of the series. What to do with it.
They like the fact that they have a halfback who can pick his way so well through defenses.
He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. Texas Tech's offense has just been dominant here in the third quarter, and it's got to be pretty demoralizing for the defense.
Yeah, the defense, I mean, they just have to get some kind of stop here to be able to get some confidence and be able to get their own offense into the position and being able to put some points up. But right now, they just cannot stop this high-powered attack.
Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds. throw. And down he goes to the 38-yard line. Throw, and he's got his receiver again.
That brings him second and five.
Mike three. Combo. Go.
He's on the run, and they got him.
That is a loss of six on the play. Third down.
They're just one quarter away. The Red Raiders lead it by two touchdowns. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Mike three.
All day, just like that. Go.
He's looking for six. Well, this offense has got to be elated. This is what they had hoped for, a stop by their defense just to give them a chance. They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, looks long enough, and he nails the long field goal.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
34-17, Texas Tech. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it two touchdowns and two possessions.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
He's hit before he could go anywhere. Fires it out.
That brings us third and 10.
Watch 32.
Check. Under pressure. Got hit and still completed it. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 36-yard line. Tackles him hard at the 48. Quick throw out to the receiver.
Mike seven. How you getting a headache?
E9.
Caught with room to work. And he is drilled at the 46-yard line. A gain of six.
You get 6 yards, and that makes picking up a first down very reasonable.
Kill.
And he's taken down around the 32-yard line.
14 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Mike seven.
Flares it out to the right, and that's to the fullback.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Hey.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Let's it fly.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly, stepped up, and what does he do? Drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
He's taken down at the 13.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
He's got to throw it in a hurry. Finds a man. Touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And he tacks on the extra point.
A 10-play, 75-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
And he's taken down at the 43-yard line.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
He has some room. Tackle made at about the 29-yard line.
First and 10. Ball on the 29. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
He fights forward to about the 29. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
That makes it second and 10.
Taking their first time out of the half. Third down, and they need to get it to the 19.
Passes it, and it's picked off by the safety. That's a great tackle at the 4-yard line.
Well, he was facing a big pass rush. The ball had no chance of being caught by one of his teammates. That's what pressure will do for any defense.
First down. This is a scary spot deep in their own territory. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
Ready! 98 Weasel! 98 Weasel!
He's going to air it long. This one is batted away.
I'm not sure the quarterback saw him when he was getting ready to pass because he stuck his paw right in the passing lane.
They come out on an empty backfield.
Red, two, blue, four. Blue, four.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up third and four.
Mike seven. Hey, kill.
Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
This guy is one of the most reliable receivers around. They needed a big play on third down, and he got it for them.
We've got a first and 10. Ball in the 23. A little over a minute in the game.
Quick pass, and they make the stop at about the 45. They'll bring him down to the 37-yard line.
Kill. Yellow, three.
Take four. That makes it second and two.
Five wide. And he throws it away. This is the eighth play of this drive. So they're going to go for it here. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. And a nice run by the tailback.
Not a lot of razzle-dazzle here, but it gets the job done and picks up the first down.
This is the 10th play of this drive. This one's going deep to the end zone. It's caught. Touchdown, Longhorns. The draw within a field goal. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A nine-play, 95-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
I think the big thing there, Brad, is that they were able to execute the passing game. When you can get big plays and great execution, obviously you're going to move the ball down the field.
The score now, 34-31. Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership. He'll go down to one knee. Texas will take their final timeout. It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 46. Texas Tech has a three-point lead. Tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ball game. And now the offense has got a chance to win it. So this one's final. Very well played by both teams today. 34-31, Texas Tech. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action of this one?
They've talked about the rivalry all week long, and for good reason. We saw the intensity down on the field every play, and it showed us why these teams love to hate each other. It'll be interesting to see how this game carries over to the next time they play.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.